Simon & Schuster Audio presents Star Trek, Sarek, by A.C. Crispin, read by Mark Lenard.
It was sunset on Vulcan. In the west, 40 Eridani A was setting in splashes of amethyst, gold, and coral. But Sarek faced east, watching Vulcan's sister world, Taruk. The watcher hung close in the sky, a huge, bloated shape dotted with raging volcanoes. It was Sarek's habit to contemplate Taruk whenever he faced a difficult decision. As he stood on his terrace, logic chains ran through his mind, presenting pros and cons. Should he act? If he did, he would break all the rules of diplomacy and interstellar law. And yet, if he did not act, millions of lives could be lost. Sarek frowned. Dare he risk interstellar war? Was this a case where the needs of the many outweighed the needs of the few? Or the one? A decision crystallized within him. Logic and necessity must outweigh ethical considerations. He must preserve the peace, even at the price of his own principles. Sarek nodded slightly at Taruk. He would leave for Earth immediately. The ambassador went to bid his wife farewell. Amanda was in her sitting room, gazing out at the rocky spires of the desert garden she had planted when Spock was a small child. When she saw her husband, she smiled. Sarek, I was going to join you on the terrace, but I must have fallen asleep.
Greetings, my wife.
The ambassador permitted himself the small smile that he reserved for her alone. Extending two fingers, Sarek ceremoniously touched them to hers, allowing the mental bond they shared to convey a depth of feeling the ambassador had never voiced aloud. Gazing down at Amanda's face, Sarek suddenly realized that she appeared drawn and pale. She'd aged in the past few weeks. Concerned, he regarded her searchingly. Amanda, you do not look well. You must consult your physician. His wife shrugged. I expect I may have picked up a cold, Sarek. Don't worry, I'll be fine. Sarek was not reassured. After informing her of his mission to Earth, the ambassador repeatedly insisted that his wife see her doctor. Finally, she sighed wearily. Very well, Sarek, but why must you go to Earth so suddenly? I wish to discuss the recent growth of the radical Keep Earth Human League. Amanda shook her head. I remember when that group was nothing but a haven for ineffectual crackpots and ignorant fools. But now, those idiots are trying to convince everyone that Vulcan is responsible for every disaster from the probe's devastation 3 years ago to the Klingon raids along the neutral zone. Her husband nodded.
The Keel's sudden growth is disquieting. I must investigate the situation personally, but I do not wish to leave you when you are ill, Amanda.
She gave him a wan smile. Don't worry about me, Sarek. I will be fine.
Perhaps I should send a message to Spock so he could be here with you.
No, Sarek. I do not want that. Promise me you will not call him.
Very well, I promise. As long as I have your word, you will see your physician, Amanda.
I promise, Sarek.
Two days later, Sarek stood at the window of the Vulcan consulate in San Francisco. Outside, a noisy demonstration by the Keep Earth Human League was gathering. He could hear their chant. The ambassador turned to find his young aide, Soren, beside him.
This sudden growth of the keel is most disturbing, Ambassador. These humans are behaving in a most illogical manner.
Sarek nodded in agreement.
They are demanding that I speak with their leader in Duna. I intend to investigate the causes of this problem personally, Soren.
Accompanied by his aide, Sarek left the consulate and walked out to face the chanting crowd. They grew louder and more strident. The ambassador walked up to the closed gates of the consulate and halted.
I am Ambassador Sarek. Which of you is in Duna?
There was a ripple in the throng. Moments later, a tall, distinguished black human stepped forth.
I am Induna. Greetings, Induna. I wish you peace and long life. I accept no good wishes from Earth's enemy.
I wish only good relations between our worlds. Will you enter the gates so we may speak together?
Induna drew himself up haughtily. I have nothing to say to you, Ambassador. I refuse to speak with a coward who hides behind locked gates.
I have nothing to hide, Induna. Very well, then. I will come to you. Sarek knew that the honor of all Vulcan was at stake as he stepped into the crowd. He could telepathically sense the hatred surrounding him, and it nearly made him ill. The Vulcan halted before the tall human.
What is it you wish of me, Induna? We demand that all Vulcans withdraw from this world forever. From now on, Sarek, leave Earth to the humans.
Suddenly, the shouting intensified and the demonstrators grew violent. A rock struck Sarek on the arm. The mob went berserk as Federation security officers moved in with crowd control stunners and force fields. Sarek was shoved forward, almost into Induna's arms, and the Keel leader struck at him. Sarek grabbed the man's shoulder, and the Vulcan's steely fingers located the proper spot and squeezed. Induna's eyes rolled up in his head, and the Keel leader collapsed. The ambassador stood in the middle of the panicking mob, stunned. The moment his fingers had closed on Induna's flesh, Sarek had telepathically sensed the human's mental state. What he sensed shocked him. Induna was under mental influence from an outside source. Someone had inflamed the man's incipient xenophobia into a raging firestorm of hatred and bigotry. And that someone was Vulcan. Later in the park-like garden behind the consulate, the ambassador walked with his young aide. Soren, the sudden growth of the keel is no accident. These humans are being influenced by off-worlders. The keel is being telepathically incited to hate and fear all aliens, but especially Vulcans. Soren regarded the ambassador, his dark eyes troubled. Do you have proof of this off-world threat, sir?
Sarek shook his head, his expression grave.
Not yet. I must gain proof of my suspicions before I can inform Federation security and the President of what I suspect. The safety of the entire Federation is at stake, Soren.
Why?
What do you mean, sir? Off-worlders are plotting to start an interstellar war. The growth of the keel is but one facet of their strategy. The handsome young Vulcan raised an eyebrow, his dark eyes widening. Please explain, Ambassador. Who do you believe is responsible for this?
Sarek regarded him questioningly. Tell me, Soren, what do you know of the Freelands?
Soren stared into the distance and concentrated. Freeland is an isolated world located near the middle of the Romulan neutral zone. The Romulans have never annexed the planet, possibly because it is so inhospitable and remote. Freeland maintains a policy of strict neutrality in all interstellar negotiations. Sarek nodded at his aide. Correct.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.